I may have an idea here. I'm just thinking out loud, but it seems to me it's up to us to convince this gentleman that we're right and he's wrong. Maybe if we each took a minute to, you know, try it on for size. Okay, let's start it off.
Oh, well, I just think he's guilty. I thought it was obvious, but nobody proved otherwise.
Nobody has to prove otherwise. The burden of proof is in the prosecution. The defendant doesn't have to open his mouth. It's in the Constitution, the Fifth Amendment. You've heard of it.
Well, sure, I've heard of it. I know what it is. What I meant, well, anyway, I think he was guilty.
Okay, let's get to the facts. Number one, let's take the old man who lived on the second floor right underneath the room where the murder took place. At 10 minutes after 12 on the night of the killing, he heard loud noises in the upstairs apartment. He said it sounded like a fight. Then he heard the kid say to his father, "I'm gonna kill you." A second later, he heard a body falling and he ran to the door of his apartment and looked out and saw the kid running down the stairs and out of the house. Then he called the police and they found the father with a knife in his chest. And the coroner fixed the time of death at around midnight. Now, what else do you want?
The boy's entire story is a little flimsy. He claimed he was at the movies. A little ridiculous, isn't it? He couldn't even remember what pictures he saw.
That's right. Did you hear that? You were absolutely right.
Look, what about the woman across the street? If her testimony doesn't prove it, then nothing does.
That's right. He saw the killing, didn't he?
Just a minute. Here's a woman who's lying in bed and can't sleep. It's hot, you know? Anyway, she looks out the window and right across the street she sees a kid stuck the knife into his father's back. She's known the kid his whole life. His window is right opposite of hers, across the L tracks, and she swore she saw him do it.
Through the windows of the passing elevated train?
Okay, and they proved that? You can look through the windows of a passing L train at night and see what's happening on the other side. They proved it.